हेलो फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर गिविंग अस वेरी ओवरवेलमिंग रिस्पॉन्स ड्यूरिंग द लास्ट 7 डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन एंड वी रियली इंस्पायरिंग फ्रॉम योर डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन एंड वी गॉट मोर एनर्जी टू डिजाइन मोर इंटरेस्टिंग एक्टिविटीज फॉर यू एंड कंडक्ट मोर इंटरेस्टिंग प्रोग्राम फॉर यू। एंड टुडे वी आर डूइंग स्पेशल प्रोग्राम फॉर यू इन कोलैबोरेशन विद IIT गांधीनगर। एंड व्हाट इज द टाइटल ऑफ द प्रोग्राम? यू ऑलरेडी नो द टाइटल, Come, fall in love with the mathematics. But before starting actual demonstration and actual live show, I would like to introduce the team over here. The here, Himayun and the Vivek is taking care of the camera, Ankish, Dinesh and Naveen taking care of the live stream, and Rohit is helping us. So before going to IIT Gandhinagar, I would like to introduce the team and basically team member of the IIT Gandhinagar. Manish Jain. He is actually taking very good initiative in the campus of the IIT Gandhinagar and set up the center called as a Creative Learning Initiative and Center for Creative Learning. The Manish and his team basically design many activities for school students and the teachers in the campus of the IIT Gandhinagar. Manish is basically graduated from the IIT Kanpur in 1993 in electrical engineering, and he worked more than 19 years in the Synopsys company who manufactures chips for the computer. And after that, about 6 years back, somehow he came in Pune and we met Padma Shri Sri Arvind Gupta and in the premises of the IUCA Pune. And you know the in IUCA very nice center called as a Children's Science Center, and somehow we work together and design many interesting activities for school students and teachers now, which is available on the arvindguptatoys.com. And after working with the IUCA Pune, actually he interested in more kind of the engineering activities, and actually somehow visited IIT Gandhinagar and thought we should have something very interesting center in the campus of the IIT Gandhinagar. So he and his team set up very interesting center which actually designed very interesting activity for school student, teachers, and not just student and the teachers, for all the science and mathematics lover. So I'm just taking you directly in his lab, Manish's lab at the IIT Gandhinagar. And see, the program is, after watching about 50 minutes demonstration, then we are coming back here again. And I would, meanwhile, what you have to do, in the chat box, you can ask the questions. We'll pick up your questions from the chat box. And again, Manish and the team will answer your questions. So I would like to, just right now, we are going to in the campus of the IIT Gandhinagar, where Manish and team, they are waiting for us. Ankish, are you ready?
Yes. Hello and welcome, Manish. Thank you very much for inviting me to come and speak to you here. My name is Manish Jain, and I am speaking to you from IIT Gandhinagar, from the banks of Sabarmati, from this place called Center for Creative Learning, where the goal of this lab is to make learning engaging and inspiring, something that can bring back the gleam in your eyes. And so today's talk about come fall in love in math is something that is exactly what we do in our lab. And this is how the lab looks like. You can see all these structures and toys and all the math toys. This is the picture of the dome. Incidentally, we made this at ISER Pune about 6 months back. And this is another dome at IIT Gandhinagar, which has been there for about a year now. And while we will talk about the goals of our lab in a little detail from now, but I would say, if you are one of those who think math is boring, hard, and just full of lifeless formulas, then this is the right place you've come to. And this is what the talk is going to be about. The talk is going to be about how we can make math engaging and inspiring, how you can come and fall in love with math. This is something exactly what we do in our lab. So if you hate maths, or if you don't like it, you're welcome to come visit our lab, of course, after the lockdown, or visit us online, at Center for Creative Learning, IIT Gandhinagar. And interestingly, ISER Pune and IIT Gandhinagar are collaborating to bring this weekend online workshop program. 30 weeks, 30 science, 30 math, 1 hour lectures followed by absolutely interesting and engaging problems and games and puzzles which will bring STEM or science and math just alive. Something that you would like to think about all your time, and something that will make this curriculum more engaging and interesting and inspiring. So to begin with, what we will do is this first thing, what we call is the math salute, right? Because this is a talk about how you can fall in love with math. Let's pray and let's give this salute, to math. Please put both your hands right in front of each other. Put your right hand, this is my right, on top of left. Of course, when you're watching, your image will be the other way. So please don't follow my image, but do, in physics you say this lateral inversion. And then turn and clasp both your hands, all right, like this. Now move your small fingers or the little fingers, move your thumb, and again the small fingers, and when you are ready, bring your hand back. And I can see if you were trying along with this, you were having a little problem. You were, maybe when you were trying like this, you just could not bring it back up. And so something was not right, okay? So let's do this again. We will bring both our hands right in front of us. We will put right on top of left. We will turn and clasp it, and then move our fingers whichever way we want. And then when the time is right, we will bring our hands back together in front. Now, I could do it, and some of you are able to do it. But the reason sometimes this works and sometimes this doesn't is the way we are clasping our hands. And so what happens in math, the reason why this salute is important is that sometimes we have to go from answer to the question, right? So this was my answer. This is how my hand finally has to be. And so a step before that was like this, right? And so then I can open my hands and keep it like this and bring it back here. And so the trick to this math thing or to this salute was that I have to move both my hands in the same direction, in the same anti-clockwise direction, and then hold it, and then I can bring it back up. However, if I turn them in both of them in other direction, then I cannot bring it back up. And so that's why the trick is to do, and this is very interesting. The reason why this concept is interesting in math is because you see, think about this problem. Let's say I have a lot of mangoes. Aajkal aam ka season hai, this is a mango season. So Pune is famous for Ratnagiri mangoes. Let's say I have lots of mangoes, and I give half and three, then half and then two, and then half and one, and then I have none. So I remember reading this story when I was young, when I was small, maybe, grade 5 or something. And then, or grade 8, I don't remember. And then what we are supposed to do is write these complex algebraic equation, assume the number of mangoes you have is X, and then, and all of that, and then finally try to solve it. And we get confused writing X. But if you see, in such kind of problems, we will have to start from the back. And you can try your answers, give us answers in your chat box. What happens if you start from the back? You start from the answer when you had none, and then you go one step back, and then you will reach at the right answer. So in math, it is very interesting sometimes to go from answer back to the question. And it is also important to draw pictures, and that is what this talk is going to be about. Draw a lot of pictures, and how drawing pictures help you really, really understand math and make math more interesting and enjoyable. Let me ask you this very simple question, or interesting question, let me put it that way. I'm assuming half of you who are watching here are women or girls, but tell me this, right? Who is the first woman to have won the Nobel Prize in math? And now you'll ask me, hey, there is no Nobel Prize in math. Well, let's call it the Fields Medal. Yes, there is no Nobel Prize in math. The equivalent of a Nobel Prize is considered this Fields Medal, which is given every once in 4 years and to people under the age of 40. And there has been only one woman in the history to have ever won the Nobel Prize. And her name was Maryam Mirzakhani. And the math that she was an Iranian woman, and unfortunately she died a few years back. She was a professor at Stanford, and she would do her math by drawing, and you can see this picture right here. She's busy drawing, you know, a lot of her math was just done by drawing these interesting pictures, and that made her really think and visualize and enjoy math at the same time. And Maryam was not very interested in math. And she says the reason of her interest in math was this beautiful story that happened about 100, 200 years ago. And this is a real story, right? There was this child, class 3 going on, and there is child sitting, and the teacher walks in and writes all the numbers from 1 to 100 on the board, and then says, why don't you tell the sum of all these numbers? And of course, you know, children started counting. 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3 is 6, and so on and so forth. Initially, you go very fast because these are small numbers, and then, you know, your speed starts on decreasing. And there is this one child sitting at the back who's not doing anything. And the teacher is a little annoyed. He says, why aren't you adding? Just like the other children, and the child says, look, I'm trying to look patterns in all of these numbers. Right? And then he says, after 2 seconds, 5,050. And the teacher is absolutely shocked. And the child says, I will count 1 and 100, that is 101, 2 and 99, 101, 3 and 98, 101, 4 and 97, 101, and so on and so forth, all 101s, 50 pairs, because there are 100 numbers, so you know, 50 pairs. 101 times 50 is 100 times 50 plus 1 times 50, which is 5050. And the teacher says, oh, please get out of my class. I don't know if this is true or not, but because I cannot give anything to you. And this child later on became Gauss. I mean, the child was Gauss always, but he became famous as Gauss, and he did lots of very interesting things. Gaussian distribution, Gauss's shoelace theorem, which is absolutely beautiful. If you have some time, please go read how to find, you know, area of any regular, irregular, you know, polygon by this theorem. So focus of today's session is to not cover any specific topics, but to excite you about math. Share those examples with you and convince you that math can be absolutely engaging and inspiring. Let's look at this very interesting activity. I thought this is something that made me just wonder about what is going on. So I have this simple piece of square where I'm going to draw an arrow pointing up. And I'm going to hold it with this hand and then flip. And then I'm going to draw another arrow pointing up. And then I'm going to hold it with this hand and flip. So you see both the arrows are pointing up. What I will do now is just change the hand. Instead of holding like this, I'm holding in the other hand. And now something beautiful happens. The arrow automatically turns downwards. If I hold it with this hand, it is turning up. If I hold it with this hand, it is turning downwards. And now something more magical happens. If I hold it now again with the same hand, now it's actually both ways downwards. So there are three situations, up and down, down and down, up and up, just by holding with different hands in different situations. So as you saw, this paper, which had this arrow, was sometimes pointing up and sometimes pointing down, even though I just changed my hands. And that makes me wonder what exactly was going on. I can hold it like this, or I can hold it like this with my right hand or left hand. How did holding of my hands made the arrow turn the other way? I mean, up versus down. And this is very engaging. This is very interesting. And this is exactly what we try to find out in our lab. This interesting math behind simple things that can be interesting and as well as very engaging. Let me elaborate on it a little bit more. Let me ask you this very simple question, and you can write in your you know, chat boxes or you know, as comments. How many of you are there who have eaten khichdi in your life? And let me tell you what khichdi is. Khichdi is boiled rice and boiled dal. So assume, since we are all math people of math, what we are trying to do is we will eat khichdi for the next 3 days. Okay, breakfast khichdi, lunch khichdi, dinner khichdi, right? Khichdi of rice. Khichdi is basically boiled rice and lentil, no namak, no salt, no tadka, anything on the side. So imagine, first day, breakfast, lunch, khichdi. Second day, breakfast, lunch, khichdi. No snacks in the middle, no chai, no nothing. Third day, same thing. Now you're getting very, very bored, right? You don't know, you have not eaten anything for 3 days other than khichdi. And so now imagine on the fourth day, if somebody shows you khichdi, what will happen? You will just feel like everything that is inside will come out. But if you see, sometimes we are doing exactly same, you know, with our curriculum. We are only serving dry things in our curriculum. Now imagine along with this khichdi, if we had some, you know, masala, some chaach, some dhokla, jalebi, and achar, and chutney, and papad, and so on and so forth, suddenly that curriculum becomes more engaging and interesting. We will need carbohydrates, but also these other micronutrients which give a lot of value if we compare it to the health of the human being. And so I think this is exactly what is missing in our math. Math has become very boring and dry and lifeless. And so we have to add these interesting activities, the stories which inspire. Maryam's story, Gauss's story, and story of Manjul Bhargav and Pandit Hemchandra. And if we get time, we will talk about all of those. How people who did beautiful maths in something completely unrelated. Arts, music, math, Manjul. So why should one do math? Right? It's an interesting question, right? And one can say, well, you know, while you see everything around you, you see internet, you see computers, you see anything that is around to do with technology, there is math behind it. But it's all behind it, right? So math will give you, you know, we can say a very utilitarian view of that math is good because, you know, if you're good at math, you get a good job and you can run your life. But there is something even more interesting and important, which is the joy that math brings to us. So let me ask you this. If you have heard about this term called quadratic equations, which if you have not, you will read in class 9, and maybe our teachers have all read about this. How many of you think you will ever use this in your life, quadratic equations? You can write your answers in, you know, comment sections. And you will realize, and if I go ask this question outside, how many of you think? The answer is very, very close to zero. Almost nobody needs quadratic equations, unless, of course, you want to, you know, work in some company that does, you know, animation movies and so on and so forth. Then you need a lot of these math and quadratic equations to do a lot of this animation. But other than that, you will never. So then why teach quadratic equations? And it's an interesting question we have to think about. Right? And I think there is a beauty in math. Right? Whenever we watch this movie, I don't know if you've seen this movie Bahubali, there is this thing of Bahubali ne Katappa ko kyun mara? Why did Bahubali kill Katappa? And that's an interesting question. Does it have anything to do with our lives? When we go watch a beautiful movie or see a beautiful painting, do we see what has that to do with our life? No. And that is exactly true for math also. Some of the stories, some of the concepts, some of the theorems, some of the you know, math behind the daily things is so engaging and inspiring that it gives us this inner joy. And that is something that is totally missing in our curriculum. And so we have to bring that back. And that is what, you know, ICER Pune and IIT Gandhinagar is working together to bring this to you. Let's take this example. How this is beautiful, right? Imagine what will happen if you ride a cycle on a circle. What will be the path taken by a pedal? And this most beautiful thing by which you see these cardioids and you know flowers kind of a thing. But imagine you are going around in a circle and your friend wants to keep some distance, fixed distance from you, let's say 1 meter. But if you are going around in a circle with let's say some speed of 1 meter per second or whatever, your friend wants to go around you but keeping the same distance at twice the speed. So somebody is circling around you at twice the speed, maintaining the same distance. What will be the path of your friend? Absolutely amazing, which is the cycloid you see here. You can do this in this tool called GeoGebra, which is where you are seeing all of this. Simple things, a ladder sliding along the floor. And this beautiful thing that we did with our interns is something that you see right here. This is called curve stitching. Right? All you do is take a circle, you divide the circle in many, many parts, and then tie strings around, and these beautiful patterns that you see. Now, art and math are coming alive by this. Beautiful math that you see. I don't know if you've seen this, but you can also try it, right? Whenever you are drinking coffee, you will saw this picture, you will see this exact same picture of this cycloid which we just discussed with your friend, you know, your friend going around. Now, why did when the light reflect draw a cardioid in your coffee mug is an interesting problem to think about. Same thing happens when you start stitching these threads around in a circle and you again see the same cardioid. Now, when you see these things happening, this complex math that we teach, polar coordinates and so on and so forth, is right there. kids in grade 5 and grade 6 can start doing this, or even younger, can start these art and craft activities and make these beautiful patterns which will make math come alive and make you fall in love with it. What we also see, what I also feel, is that sometimes we go into too much details where that is not required. Let me give you an example. What do you think is the answer? Please, this seems like a simple question, but you know, there was a lot of interest, there was a lot of confusion on the internet as to what the real answer is. Please type your answers in this comment section. And while this is lockdown, of course you can hear the birds around. Birds are actually enjoying while we are locked down. So some of you have written the answer is 16 and some are saying the answer is 1. And we will fight about it. We will say no. And the point is that, of course, this boils down to 8 divided by 2 times 4. Right? And so now the question is, which one should we do first? Should we divide first and should we multiply first? No, my teacher taught Bodmas, and so I have to do this. And while it is okay, right, if you make some rules, then it is fine. But I think sometimes you get so much stuck in this detail, which is unimportant. Nobody will give you this kind of math in your life. It's like saying this English phrase, eats, shoots and leaves. Now it's very confusing what the person really meant. And there are many meanings, right? The person comes, eats the shoots and leaves and goes away, or comes, shoots somebody and then leaves. Now, that's why there is something called punctuation in English. And similarly, there are brackets in math. And we have to use that. The whole point of teaching math is not to penalize you for things that are useless. I will rather put a bracket around it and then make your life easier. And so this is an example that I thought I wanted to talk about, because when this question came on the internet, all the teachers were up in rage, you know, oh, this is the answer. And if you are getting the answer as 1, then you don't know any math. Or if you're getting answer in 16, you probably failed, and so on and so forth. And that's not the idea. The idea is to make math engaging and inspiring. Let me ask you this very simple question. I hope this is something that we will communicate this. So when you add two numbers, we always go from, right to left. We will add units, then tens, then hundreds and thousands. Okay, when we do subtraction, we do the same thing. Units, tens, hundreds, thousands. When we multiply, we do the same thing, right? But when we divide, we go the other way. We go from 1,000, then 100, then 10, and 1. And why do we do that? And we don't have that answer, right? And it's interesting. Please do this. This is sort of an exercise. Send us an email at to ICER or to us at cli@iitgn.ac.in. We will send the email in the description also. And of course, you have to divide it the right way. Right way, just like you add, just like you subtract, just like you multiply, you start from the right. It's called the right way. It also, but in our schools, we will read it. The most interesting thing is, while we do from the left, the point is that, do we really understand why we do what we do? For instance, if it doesn't go, we will write a 0 behind a 3. Why do we do that? What does it really mean? What is the math that is going behind? That is something that is very important for us to discuss and talk about. Something that is conceptually interesting and can also bring back the joy. For instance, you can just multiply two numbers by using your fingers. So let me write these numbers for you. So what I have is these numbers on my fingers. I have written numbers from 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, all these 5 numbers. And I'm going to multiply 7 by 8, right? 7 by 8. So for that, what I have to do is count the fingers on top. These fingers, this is 3 and this is 2. So 3 times 2 is 6. And the fingers at the bottom, count the number of fingers at the bottom. This is 3 and 2, 5. So what I have to do is 5 times 10 and plus the previous, which is 6, 56. And you will see that this works for any number. Please try it for, let's say, 8 times 9. And you will realize that to do this multiplication, you need to know only tables till 4. And the most interesting thing is not how this trick works, but why it works. And that's the most beautiful thing when I write about it. This was done in Russia after the First World War, when because of the destruction, they lost a lot of things. And so what they started to do was using this activity to teach tables till class 10, the 10 in number. And the most interesting thing about this activity I found was the algebra behind. Can you show that this activity works for any number Not just the one that I took, 8 and 7. Prove that it always works. Then you can go on another step. You can say, what if I use both my hands and I write numbers from, use all my 10 fingers and write numbers from 1 to 10. Show me that how the same activity will work and prove that it always works. And then I can extend it. That it always works for all the way from numbers from 11 to 20. So basically, I can use the same trick or same activity to multiply all the numbers from 1 to 20, and there is beautiful algebra behind to prove that it always works. So this is another, let's call it homework, and if you do, please send us an email or type in this comment section, what is the algebra behind this math? And specifically, if you have numbers from 11 to 20, how will you use your fingers to multiply 11 to 20 using similar technique and then prove that this always works? There are numerous other activities that we can do to make math exciting and engaging. You can do things with A4 sheets, and we will show you something beautiful with this A4 sheet. In fact, A4 sheet is beautiful in itself. We can do hundreds of activities in math with just a simple sheet of paper because of the property of A4 sheet. I don't know if you know that this A4 sheet has a specific ratio of length is to breadth, right? And that ratio is a magical number. And I don't want to give you the answer. For some of those who know this, please type that answer in the comment section. It's a beautiful number, and we can actually prove without knowing any math what this number is. Because A4 sheets have this magical property that if you tear the A4 in half, it becomes A5. But the ratio of the length of breadth is the same as A4, which means half of A4 has the same ratio as A4. And just by that fact, I can show or prove, please do that, please try doing that and send us an email that ratio is square root of 2. We will prove that in the next episode when we work with you. We can use these cards to do absolutely amazing, interesting activities in math, we are going to show some of that. I have 5 of these cards here. 5 red and 5 black, and I'm going to keep this in 2 decks, and I'm going to shuffle them from top to bottom, and I can do it from any of these 2 piles as you desire. Of course, Mera Bharat Mahan, so I'll keep counting Mera and the volunteer that's here. If you want me to change from, instead of shuffling this deck, the other one, just say change. So M I will start with here. I could have done with any other one. So, Mera, M, E, R, A, and I get these 2 cards. I will open it up. Again, Bharat, B, H, A, R, A, T, H. Very nice. Mahan, M, A, H, A, N. Again, this time we didn't shift at all. And magically, it still works. Jai Hind, I'll start here, J, A,
shift.
I, H, I, N, last one here, same one, okay, yes. D, and now, which also means that this last card have to be the same. So no matter which way I shuffle, which cards I shuffle, Mera Bharat Mahan, Jai Hind will always work. And this activity just follows very simple rules of math. Of course, you can do this activity and impress your friends. But if you don't want to do that and understand, this actually works just understanding the modulo math or how things go around in a circle. So please try this activity at home. If you have any questions, by the way, please write any of your questions in comment section and we would be very happy to answer you or send us an email. We can do absolutely amazing activity yet again with the same playing cards. And what I have now is, some cards, 14 cards actually. This joker, we call it zero, but other than that, 13 cards, all of the same suit, and they are all shuffled. And you can see that they are in no particular order. And I have, all these cards have some holes and slits that I have drawn. You can see that. And what I'm do is I will try to see if I can sort them just by using this refill, used refill. So I'm going to put this here in this hole. Some cards will come out. I will put them in front, do the same thing. Pull all these cards out, put them in front. The second hole is done. I will put the same thing in the third hole. Put these cards out, put them in front. And then I'm going to see, you can actually already see that zero is in front, but you know, put this out and then bring back in front. And now let's see what happens. 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Zero. And the math behind the whole activity is absolutely interesting. I'm sure you can figure out that I have made these holes as a binary representation. For those who don't know, you can go check it out or look at our activity on our on our YouTube channel. And then what we did was something more interesting. I'm not going to show you, but you can try it on your own as a homework. But then what we did was the same activity we did with 27 cards. How to sort 27 cards, but this time I have three holes only, not four, three holes, one, two, and three. Except the holes are of three different kinds. One is a circular hole, one is a full slit, and the other one is a hole, but it has a small hole at the top. And just by using that, I can sort 27 cards. The math behind this is absolutely amazing. And you can try this at home, and if you are not, and if you think it doesn't work for you, wait for the next episode or send us an email or write it in the comment section, and we will be very happy to tell you how this works. But you should, all of these activities, the best thing is that you have to try this on your own. All you need is just simple playing cards and bunch of holes. We will also put the PDF of how you have to make these holes in each of these numbers for them to work. So please look at that in the description. There are some amazing things you can do with 3D structures. Can you guess what this shape looks like? It's basically a cuboid. The volume of this thing is 2 liters, 2000 cubic centimeter. This side is 10. So it's a square on one side and it's double the square on the other side. So it's basically 2 cubes side by side. So its volume is 2000 cc or 2 liters. And what I'm going to do is to convert this cuboid without breaking it into pieces in a cube. And what I'm going to do now is just put it like this and then put it like that. So 7 pieces and now it's a cube. The volume of course remains the same because all the pieces are here. And now the side which was 10 centimeter becomes 12.6 centimeters. The cube remains the same. So 12.6 cube is basically roughly equal to 2000 cc. So these things are called hinged dissections, where the whole structure of the solid becomes something else just by changing, and none of the pieces come out. Absolutely amazing to figure out what is size of each of these pieces so that you can do this 2 cube to 1 cube. This is something also very interesting. I have these simple cuboid and I'm going to fold. And so it becomes a cube. But something very interesting happens. It becomes a blue cube or a red cube, green cube. But I can also pull the whole thing out and I can make 2 stars out of it. So of course you can guess, if these two are 2 stars, then their volume must be half of the cube, because I can put one of these like that, the other one like this, and then stick it in. They basically complement each other. These kind of toys and activities bring back a different definition of math, provide a different meaning to math that we are doing. This is something you might not have seen before. These are basically 4 small pyramids, triangular pyramids. The base is a triangle and it's a pyramid. And what I can do is just I can fold this to make a cube. And the most interesting part is this cube is hollow from inside. And what fits inside is actually a tetrahedron. So you can see tetrahedron is basically cube minus four of these triangular pyramids. So four of these triangular pyramids and a tetrahedron makes a cube. Absolutely beautiful and brings back that gleam in the eyes. And if you are bored doing math, this is what you might want to do. And you can use sticks, broomsticks from your house along with this atta dough and make these beautiful structures. I'm just showing you this interesting structure called the tetrahedron. But you can make, you know, all of those structures, all these platonic solids, tetrahedron, square, octahedron, and we can discuss this in details, the properties of some of these structures. And I will show you some of those. Icosahedron, which is sitting here, and then dodecahedron, all five platonic solids, and many, many more. You know, you truncate them and you get Archimedean solids and Catalan solids and Johnson solids. All of those are some things that we have built in our lab, as you can see in this picture of our lab. You're sitting along, seeing a lot of these solids, which are all, you know. And this brings the, and these wonderful lamps that decorate the ceiling of IIT Gandhinagar. The goal was to, this was done by our, you know, math students. You can see how art and math can come together and make this. And when you see these lamps lighting, this is so beautiful. It just gives pure joy. So that is the idea, to share some of those things with you. Like I said, we have created hundreds of such activities in our lab, which are absolutely unique. And I'm going to show you a couple of them and maybe also give you a demo. For instance, this device, which we call sometimes the hathoda, looks like a hathoda, but it's actually an angle trisector invented about hundreds of years ago. And we'll see how it trisects any angle. And it's basically just a circle and a straight line here. It can trisect any angle and uses the basic property of mathematics that we learn, or geometry that we learn in our middle school. So I don't know what this angle is, but it could be any angle. And I can use this device to actually trisect the angle. What I have to do is I have to put the corner of this angle in this slit, one of these lines as tangent, and other line should fall in this hole. That's it. Yes, here you go. So the joint is here. This point is the tangent to this circle. This is another point where this line meets, and I mark these two points. And with that, I have trisected my angle. These three angles are exactly equal. Why should this be a trisector? Why should this trisect is beautiful. I can draw this. This is actually a straight line because these three were in a straight line. And this is 90 degrees because it's tangent. So I leave this to you as an exercise. If you can prove it, send us an email as to why these three angles must be equal. And what we did was something else. We also did this trisector using this device. As you can see here, the birds around, it is good to hear the sounds of the birds. I mean, I am very happy for that part, that there are so many birds around now, which we were not you know, hearing before. So you see this angle of 120 degrees and this thing automatically has trisected. I can keep moving up and down, and any angle that I keep, this device trisects, and it beautifully uses the properties of congruence of triangles. All these things here, these four triangles that you see here, are congruent, and that is the reason this trisector works. So it is good to make this activity and then go and find out the math, play with it, and then find out why this works as it really works. These are toys all designed in our lab. You get these sheets and all these pieces come out, and you can join these pieces, no glue required. This is MDF, medium density fiber wood, and you can use all of these pieces that come out joined together by these rubber bands and make these beautiful toys. This is basically Archimedean Trammel, and we made a 6 version of the same thing. This toy is absolutely amazing. We call this the pentasector. In fact, I'm showing this here right now, but this was invented in IIT Gandhinagar. It doesn't exist anywhere else. When we did this trisector, we thought, why don't we extend? Is it possible to extend this trisector so that it can just, pentasect an angle? In fact, this device is interesting because it trisects, it divides an angle in 3 parts, 4 parts, 5 parts, and actually 6 parts. All, it does all 6. So it's a, mega angle, whatever you want to call it, right? And this we invented, created in our lab in CCL, Center for Creative Learning. I urge you to make this device on your own. Send us a picture or videos of how you did it and let us know how it works. Essentially, it's just a replica of this trisecting device. It's basically a mirror of trisect. I'm basically giving you the answer, but then it'll be nice for you to sort of make this, and you can make this just with a piece of simple cardboard. Absolutely beautiful when you see how it works to pentasect an angle and hexasect, and then prove why this worked. The most interesting thing about all of these activities is that, one, of course, we know how to do it, but the major gleam in the eyes or the joy that happens with math is when we prove why this works. You can do so much interesting math with calendar. Calendars are there in every school, every class, every houses. Of course, maybe these days we just use calendars on our phones, but largely in all our houses. But the only thing that we use the calendar for is to find out what's the next holiday. And in fact, these days, because of lockdown, there are too many holidays. But calendar can help us do so much interesting math. Absolutely. You can do means, you can do averages, you can do arithmetic progressions, you can do magic squares. There is a book written by P.K. Srinivasan called Calendar Fun with Math, and it has about hundreds of activities that you can do. And we will show you this magic 1000 year calendar, this device that you are seeing right now. With just these 12 magic numbers, you can find out any date. For instance, if today is 26th of July, what's the day on 26th of July? And this magic calendar can tell you any day in thousands of years. So you don't need to carry thousands of calendar. Just these 12 numbers can magically show you. There is beautiful modulo 7 math which is going behind, which is making this calendar work. So let's find out. Let's say today is 26th of July 2020, and we have to find out what day it is. So what we will do, the basis for this activity or this 1000 year calendar is, we assume that the 1-1-1, that is 1st January 2001, was a Monday. So how do we do this? Let's say 26th July 2020, we will take 25 from here, and then we will add to that this 7th month, which is July. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is, we will add 6. For 2020, it is 19 years from 2001. So we will add 19. This is 1-1-2001. And then 2020 divided, 20 last two digits divided by 4 is 5. So we will add another 5 here. And if we add all of these things up, we will get 25 plus 5, 30, 30 plus 19, 49, 49 and 6, 55. And if we divide that by 7, we get remainder as 6, right? And so we must be 6 days from 1-1-2000, 6 days ahead of 1-1-1 or Monday. So 6 days ahead of Monday is Sunday. So it must be Sunday, the best day of our month or the best day of our week. A lot of time we think about math as boring and mathematicians as the ones with Well, long hair, I don't have much, but long hair and even more boring, right? And all their lives are, they're just writing on sheets of paper and working over boring formulas. No, but their lives can be very inspiring. And those are the things that we need to talk about. When I was young, I used to think a lot about this number pi. Why does it exist only in circles and so many times, everywhere? Area of a circle, pi. Circumference, pi. Volume of a cone, pi. Surface area of a cone, pi. Everything that has to do with circle, there is a pi. So I was wondering that pi is always something to do with circle, except when I read this very interesting story about 200 years ago. This was invented by this man called Buffon, and it's called the Buffon's needle problem, right? And you see this right here. All you have to do is just draw these lines on your floor. With the distance between these parallel lines equal to twice the matchstick, and drop a lot of these matchsticks randomly on the floor, and you will find that some of the matchsticks touch the line and some don't, and the ratio of the total sticks to the number of sticks that touch the line is pi. Now, how did nature know that at a random, if I drop, you know, 1000 sticks, about 314 will touch the line, if I drop them randomly, of course. This is absolutely amazing. This story can make children wonder. This made me wonder for weeks before I realized what is going on. Where is the circle in these parallel lines? And it broke the myth about this absolutely beautiful number called the pi, of course. So let me tell you this story about this guy, Archimedes. Please tell us, what do you think this man is most famous for? You know, he was famous because of buoyancy and flotation, and he was sitting in a bathtub and he ran out crying naked, Eureka, Eureka. And because he found out something very interesting. But if you ask Archimedes what he thinks is the most interesting contribution of his life to mankind, he would give you a different answer. Archimedes was the first person to figure out the volume of a sphere, 4 by 3 pi r cube. And that he found without using calculus, because calculus was invented 1600 years later. He used just a cylinder, a cone, and a sphere to figure out this volume. He used the Pythagoras theorem and laws of liver. Give me a liver long enough and I can raise the earth. He just used those two principles, and the proof is absolutely elegant. When I read this proof, I said, this is a much better proof than what we teach. In fact, it should precede what we teach in calculus. And interestingly, the most interesting part about Archimedes' story is that while he was doing his proof, there were orders from the king to chop his head. And there is a Roman soldier, you can see in this picture, who's trying to chop his head. And Archimedes says, well, you can do that, but before you do, please make sure you don't rub the things that I've written on the floor, because that is my contribution to the mankind. And so Archimedes actually laid down his life. He was killed. His head was chopped. On his tomb, you can still see a figure of a cone, a sphere, and a cylinder. These are stories that bring math alive. This was a real person, the first person to find the volume of a sphere, and how he was brutally killed. Not because of his invention, but actually, you know, later on it was found it was a mistake. But nonetheless, these stories bring math alive. And these are the stories that need to go inside our classrooms. Math also gives us lots of different perspectives. This is something that is very interesting. This is a structure called the diamond. It's also called an octahedron because it has 8 triangles, as you can see. But I can also say, this is the same structure. This is basically 3 squares that are put together in 3 different planes, x, y, and z, right? So these two are exactly same. 3 squares and 8 triangles, exactly the same thing. So there can be various different interesting perspectives of looking at the map, and we have done the same thing for all 5 platonic solids. Similarly, if you take this sheet of paper and you roll it, it looks like a cylinder. So if you look at this cylinder from the top, you should see a circle. If you see it like this, you should actually see a rectangle. And what I'm going to do now is keep it circular and then just hold it like this and make a cut, a slant cut, such that I don't fold it, I don't press it, but just make a slant cut. And of course, And if you see from it like this here, you should actually see an ellipse. But something magical happens when I open it up. And I see a sine wave. So cylinder circle, ellipse, rectangle, and a sine wave. And something even more interesting happens when I, you know, the first cut that I made, I kept it in form of a cylinder and then made it. Now let me just press this and then make the same cut. Again, I make the same cut, except this time I have pressed it and now I'm making the same cut. And so what you should see now is a triangular wave. And the best part about this different perspective is that we will learn this definition of a sine wave in our classes, but if we were to sort of say why, if I cut a cylinder at an angle, it leads to a sine wave when we unroll, proving that just brings the real joy. We might know the definition, but just showing that this is actually a sine wave. And interesting thing is that the more slant I make this cut, the amplitude of the wave changes, but it still remains a sine wave. Math can also sometimes stump you in some of the most non-intuitive ways. And the math behind it is so beautiful. I was shocked there was this when I read about it. For those who have these washing machines at home or refrigerators or chairs, sometimes the floor is uneven and they are wobbly, right? Three legs sit on the floor, but the fourth one, you know, keeps on shaking. And so what we do is we will stick some, a piece of paper underneath and it stops for a while and then paper becomes wet and then again the thing starts wobbling. Except the most interesting thing is the math guarantees that if you just turn the whole thing, your refrigerator within 45 degrees, you will find a point that all four legs will touch the ground no matter how uneven the floor is. And you can see this in this video. Beautiful, absolutely wonderful. And the math is very interesting behind. So this, these are the kind of things that I feel we really enjoy and we want to sort of share with you. And then we can also talk about the concepts behind, the mathematical concepts behind some of these things which make it interesting. In our lab, we have created these beautiful toys, hundreds of beautiful toys out of MDF, designed these beautiful toys, which of course, if you are interested, send us an email. These toys come alive. This is a car which when moves, draws a sine wave. The car moves in one direction, the pen moves perpendicular, but when the both of them move together, this draws a sine wave. You can just make this car on your own. There is no glue. These pieces are all designed in this sheet. They all come out. You can use the rubber bands and then you can make your own car and draw, and you can play with it, right? It draws a sine wave. And then when you do this, you can try to figure out why is it that this makes a sine wave? Why not something else? It could have chosen to make anything, but it chose to draw a sine wave. So there must be something magical or something mathemagical. There must be something mathemagical conceptual behind why it drew a sine wave. But this other car, which is almost similar to this car, it draws a triangular wave. And we will see how it does that. Beautiful, absolutely wonderful. And what we also did was then for those who have done, much older, you will see something called the Fourier transform or Fourier series. You add these two sine waves and when they move, it will add these two sine waves and draw the addition of two sine waves. And if I can, if I do 10 of such modules, then I get a Fourier transform. And we have designed hundreds of such things in our lab. And as part of this thing we call the STEM box, there are 200 such things that we have packaged and we want to see how we can get it to the schools so that our teachers can lay their hands on it, our children can lay their hands on it and learn, play with these things and then of course learn with those. Math has also these beautiful concepts of puzzles which really engage our mind. And some of them are very old and can take you hours to solve. So like this ring rope puzzle, there are these things, this has holes here, and the goal is to extract this rope out of it. This is also called the Chinese ring puzzle. It is closely related to that. And there is a lot of binary math sitting here. Or this stack it up, which requires you to put all these four cubes on top of each other with four different colors, such that in each of the columns, all the colors are different. In each of the columns, right? And it needs a lot of very interesting math, maybe graph theory to actually solve it. Or this 2000 year old puzzle called the Stomachion. Interestingly invented by Archimedes about 2000 years ago. And it has taken almost 2000 years for us to solve it. It was just solved a few years ago by a professor of math in the US. We have created hundreds of such toys, and I believe that if these toys can excite a 48 year old like me and some of my colleagues who are much younger, by the way, then it can definitely engage you and make you fall in love with math. That is the real goal. I feel this is what is required to make math curriculum more engaging and inspiring. The curriculum of Khichdi needs to be sprinkled with the things that I've shown you or demonstrated. And so in the end, I will leave you with this puzzle. We call it the Diwali puzzle, and we would be very happy to hear from you. If you do solve it, please send us an email, cli@iitgn.ac.in. And the puzzle goes like this. We call it the Diwali puzzle. On Diwali, me and my wife invited four other couples to come to our house. Everybody was excited to meet each other. Some people hugged each other, like there is a custom on Diwali, people hug each other. Some people hugged each other, some actually did not. But no person hugged his or her own spouse. No person hugged her spouses. And then when this thing was, and nobody hugged any person more than once. I then asked everybody, including my wife, how many persons did you hug? And interestingly, everybody gave a different, unique answer. And the question is, how many people did my wife hug? So the rules are very simple. There are total 10 people in the house. Everybody hugs however many people that they want to, except they hug one person not more than once, and they don't hug their spouses. And when I asked them, everybody gave a different answer as to the number of people they hugged. And the question is, how many people did my wife hug? So if you think about it, send us an answer. Some of the activities that we've done, some of the videos that we do are in the description, in the YouTube description below. Like I was saying before, IIT Gandhinagar and ICER Pune are collaborating to create this weekend online massive workshops on science and math, which we will broadcast every Saturday and Sunday. 1 hour program, 1 to 1.5 hour program, followed by interesting problems, interesting questions related to what we have discussed, something that also relates to your curriculum, and something that is also engaging and inspiring. So we'll let you know when that program happens. Thank you so much for watching. It was a pleasure to come and talk to you here. And thank you so much for inviting me to come and speak here. And so with that, I will end my talk. I hope if you were the ones who really hated math, didn't like it, found it lifeless, hopefully there has been some sort of engagement, some sort of love that has happened between you and the subject. Now let's go back to Ashok from Gandhinagar to Pune.
Manish, we really thank you very much for such a wonderful talk. I hope all the students and the teachers, not only students and the teachers, but all the mathematics lover, they enjoyed your talk very much. We are again connecting to the Manish after a few minutes. But before that, I would like to mention what Manish mentioned, the Maryam Mirza Khan, the Iranian mathematics. We have added the film in the description box. So please, after this demonstration, you can watch that film. Another thing is, as you know, every Sunday we conduct some interesting activities for you. So next Sunday we are planning some chemistry activities for you. And please, to get the more notification, you have to subscribe ICER Pune Science Activity Center YouTube channel. And again, you can subscribe CCL IIT Gandhinagar YouTube channel also to get more interesting activity. So, next talk will be on the chemistry. Now, we are again reconnecting to the Manish, and so many questions we got in the chat box. So, basically, we have the collected the questions from the chat box, and Manish and the team will be happy to answer your questions. But before that, I would like to say thank you Manish and his team members who supported Manish for making this event more effectively and interestingly. Again, for the question answer session, we are going back to IIT Gandhinagar for question answer session. Ankish, are you ready?
Yes, sir, we are ready.
Yes.
Yes, sir. We are now online.
It is good to be back again. Thank you, Ashok. I hope you liked the talk, everybody. We had lots of these questions.
Yes,
I really
like
reading a flurry of these questions.
Be back again. Thank you, Ashok.
The Boardmas question where
you liked
the talk.
Everybody,
we had lots of these questions. I really like reading.
And we can now
flurry of these questions.
Be back again. Thank you, Ashok.
The Boardmas question where you liked the talk.
Everybody,
we had lots of these questions. I really like reading.
And we can now.
And so now we can go back.
Gaurav, if you have collected some questions, we can go back and answer some of those.
I really like
these start
reading.
And we can now.
And so now we can go back.
Gaurav,
some people were asking questions.
We can go back
look at some of these videos
so
we have
this channel
and we can now
with us
now
we can decide
what are
we
some
people
are asking
questions
we can look at
some of
these videos
so
we have
this
channel
and we can
now
with us
now
we
can decide
what
are
we some people
are asking
this is
the channel
we can look at
some of
these videos
so we have
youtube.com
this
channel
ID GMCLI
facebook.com/GMCLI
so
this is
the channel
this is our
website
some
of you
are
asking some
interesting
books that you can
read about
events,
and
I think if we can read only this person, the channel
Martin
Gardner,
I hope my screen is visible.
Some of you are asking some interesting books that you can read about events,
and
I think if we
can
read only this person,
can you just unmute all
the
things behind you?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Asking. Just unmute all the things behind you. Behind your laptops and all those things should be muted.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And desktop also. Just behind you, behind your laptops and all those things should be muted.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And desktop
so,
also.
Let me just
behind you.
Because you were talking about books, only one book you can read,
and
that is something that inspired me a lot, and something that really like. Martin Gardner talking about books.
He was
only one book you can read,
and
something that inspired me a lot.
All he did was just write these books.
Really like.
Every month for 25 years, he was
writing
a beautiful story about math,
and
all his work has been.
All he did was just write these books.
Editions.
Really like.
Every month
for
25 years.
Some of the things that we do in math can be so beautifully profound. If I can say, almost like watching a movie.
We can first fix the sound and then maybe we can try again. Now, as of now, going in, two sounds are getting mixed up. We can first fix the sound and then maybe we can try again. Now, as of now, going in, two sounds are getting mixed up. We can first fix the sound and then maybe we can try again. Now, as of now, going in. Two sounds are getting mixed up.
Is this almost like a trailer? And of course,
now,
in the next
now,
episode,
so
in the coming episode, we will go in detail in every single one of these.
This
we go and talk about why the color, and of course,
out of
the next episode, we will divide from the right side in detail in every single
how to make
this 27 card trick. How the, Mera Bharat Mahan Jai Hind, how that worked. Somebody asked, how did you make 2 cube to 1 cube? Of course, we can, by the way, you should also look at the description. in this chat box, I mean, in the video, where we will actually have the homework. I don't know if you noticed, there is a place to do the homework, and we would really like all of you to come and look at those absolutely interesting problems and submit your homework. And of course, the answers will also be there in a separate link. So look at the homework, look at the description, which will have details about each and every single activity. And for the explanation of those activities, we will come, that those will come in the next episode. Like I'm saying, that every Saturday and Sunday, we will be these kind of activities on math, on science, 30 weeks, which IIT and ISR are doing together. Somebody was also asking these questions about fractions. Absolutely, absolutely interesting things about fractions, because you asked, let me just give you this simple fraction problem, and you don't have to write any equation to solve it. Give me just half, I'm hoping you can see my screen. Assume there are some people in a village, some are men, some are women, and assume that 3/4 of men.
Hello, Manish sir, hello.
Yeah.
So can you just repeat the same thing again, because there was some noise issue.
Okay.
So can you just repeat for your viewers?
Sure. I can thank you so much for interrupting and asking me to repeat. I will do that very happily. So what I was saying was that I hope your screen is visible. This is our channel, youtube.com/IITGNCLI, IIT Gandhinagar, Center for Creative Learning. If you search, that should be also there. You can subscribe to the channel, Facebook, email, and website. This is all right here. What I was saying about the books is that I think if we read just one book, or these, or maybe these three authors, I think we will just develop fabulous interest in this subject. Martin Gardner, who was actually a journalist, and for 25 years, every month he would publish one story of math every month, and all of those work has been collected. He died a few years ago, but all his work is now documented in the books. One chapter, every chapter has beautiful story. Dudny, who wrote this book 200 years ago, and Perelman, a Russian author, also about a similar time ago, and maybe about 100 years ago. All these books are actually there on the internet for free, archive.org or some other website, they will have it. Please do download these books and read. That is what will engage you and give you some food, some interesting, tadka, dhokla, whatever, other than the khichdi. So please do that. We will also have a description of all these books in the description section. The most important thing about description section is the homework. So till the time of next episode, till the time we come alive with the next math episode, you will have these interesting 4 or 5 or 6 beautiful math problems which you have to think about. And send us your answers in the same Google form. What I was also going to say was that, yes, a lot of you were asking, ye kaise, all details mein bataiye, samjhaiye. Kisi ne bola, Hindi mein bhi boliye. So, hum koshish karenge ki agli baar ka session hum Hindi mein hi pura rakh lein. Usme ye hota hai ki Dakshin Bharat ke logon ko kam samajh mein aata hai. Main, of course, Hindi aur Angrezi dono bol paata hun. So, let me continue in English. The most interesting thing is, this was just a trailer. Aur ye sari explanation, राइट हैंड से डिविजन कैसे चलेगा, फिंगर मल्टीप्लीकेशन हाउ डिड इट वर्क, राइट?
वन व्यूअर आल्सो सेड व्हाई, व्हाई डू यू मल्टीप्लाई लाइक दिस, बिकॉज मल्टीप्लाइंग नॉर्मली इज इजी, सो व्हाई बॉदर मल्टीप्लाइंग विद फिंगर्स,
मेबी यू कैन वेरीफाई. ब्यूटीफुल क्वेश्चन, एंड थैंक यू फॉर हूएवर आस्क्ड दैट क्वेश्चन. व्हाई इज इट दैट वी आर डूइंग इफ इट इज सो इजी? द आइडिया इज नॉट टू गिव यू एनीथिंग डिफिकल्ट, but the idea is to show that a simple activity like this, by the way, of course, you need to know only tables till 4 to learn up till 10 using this activity. So, but that's a very small fayda, but benefit. The biggest thing that we are doing this math activity or with fingers is that you can learn algebra by that. Once you do this activity, try to prove that it always works for any numbers. 11 to 20, let's say we write numbers from 11 to 20 on our fingers, 10 fingers on this hand and 10 on your friend's hand, write numbers from 11 to 20, touch the fingers, use the same technique and show. Now, do you remember the table of 19? You probably don't, right? You know only tables till 10, right? But using this activity and knowing only tables till 10, you will be able to figure out the answer. The most interesting thing, like I said, was not the activity itself, but the math behind why it works. And go back to the YouTube video that you just saw. There is a hint that we have given in a slide about this algebra, why it works. So the whole idea is to give you something that you can do with your hands. and then relate the algebra with that. So that makes algebra more alive. So that is a short answer or a long answer to your question. Somebody asked about fraction. I was going to do this, and so I said, let me give you one more interesting math fraction problem, which we don't want you to write any equations. So assume there are some men and women in the village. We don't know how many. 3/4 of the men are married to 4/5 of the women. And the only thing is, every man marries only one woman, 1:1. Ek aadmi ki ek hi aurat ke saath shaadi hogi, and ek aurat ki ek hi aadmi ke saath shaadi ho sakti hai. One cannot marry many. And so 3/4 of the men are married to 4/5 of the women. What percentage of population is unmarried? Okay, unmarried. Kitne logon ki, what percentage of population is unmarried, or what fraction of population is unmarried? So please try to think about this question. We do not want any equations. We want you to only draw pictures, and then by drawing pictures, come up with the answer. Post that in the chat section or send us an email at cli@iitgn, or send us an email wherever you like. We are hoping to come like I said, those 30 episodes that we are going to broadcast with explanations, with detailed explanations for all of these activities. This was just a trailer to show you that math does not need to be boring. It doesn't need to be only formulas. It can be right
so,
there.
Just I wanted to add, one viewer was also asking that story that you mentioned about math and music. So,
oh, beautiful. Yeah. Please go look at this this movie called Maths, Music and Manjul. In fact, that was a movie that we made in Pune while I was in Pune. Please search Math, Music and Manjul. You will find this story. Manjul Bhargav is a person of Indian descent who have won a Fields Medal a few years ago. And so he claims that he was inspired to do math by, the music. For those who don't know, this Fibonacci numbers that we call were actually Hemchandra numbers. And please look at that video. You will realize how beautiful things are. Let's say you have a 2-beat taal. I'm just giving you a brief flavor. Let's say you have a 2-beat taal. 2 seconds lagte hain ek taal ko. Dha, 2 seconds. And dhin is 1 second. Now using dha and dhin, how many different taals you can make with 8 seconds? So you can say dha, 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 dha. So 4 dha, which is 8 seconds. Or you can say din, 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 8 times. So how many different taals can you make? This was a question that people used to ask 1200 years ago. And one Pandit Hemchandra actually came up with the answer. And that is how he basically coined, wrote the theory or proved this thing, which we called Fibonacci number. Actually, they are Hemchandra numbers. And when Manjul read this Sanskrit shlok, which actually proved this thing, it was so beautiful. You don't have to do any combinatorics. Just interesting picture and you get the answer. You just draw these pictures. Just watch that new movie, Math, Music and Manjul. Math, Music, Manjul. Please search and watch this movie on YouTube. I'm sure you will like, and you will see the connections. There are many, many connections in maths and science. Like somebody was asking, traffic light se iska kya lena dena hai, right? Or to give a short answer, if all of us get engaged in doing beautiful math in our houses, maybe the traffic problem will also reduce. Kam log sadkon mein bahar jayenge aur faltu mein idhar udhar jana band karenge. We will be busy reading Martin Gardner's book. But of course, the way to look at this is basically computational thinking and graph theory, right? People have modeled traffic problems using these graphs, right? Kis node par kahan kahan se log aa rahe hain? And then you try to use computational thinking, computer science algorithms to figure out where we should have real traffic lights, where we should have traffic lights for what, how many times or how many seconds they should be on. Synchronize kaise kare taki ek light khuli hai to dusri sahi time par pahunche with the speed of 30 the other should. So a lot of these things involve math, which of course all our municipalities and municipal corporations actually use the services of computer science and math to actually solve these problems. But our goal is to see how you can get engaged and excited to do all of these things. And right from school, and write for all those people who have joined from all parts of India. I actually could see that this time a lot of people joined from various parts of India, a lot of people from Kendra Vidyalaya and so on and so forth. It was very heartening to see all of you. I will also take just a minute and introduce, I actually don't have my slides, old slides right now, but I would like to really thank all of the CCL team and bring that bring them on the screen. Let me just bring them on the screen.
So sorry to disturb you, but a few teachers are also from Navodaya Vidyalaya, so they are also inspired from you.
So for all those who are there from Navodaya Vidyalaya also, please, you are absolutely welcome. Okay, for some reason I cannot. So I wanted to thank, hopefully people are online. You can see the screen. I hope you can see the screen. This is an old picture that we have of our. So I wanted to thank Neeraj, Gaurav, Pankaj, Ravi is there in the picture, but probably not. He's not working with us now. And Sarita and JD, Pankaj, Mihika, everybody who has contributed, everybody who worked, who works at the CCL to make, to get this talk out to you today. So this is our young team. Like I said, I'm in my talk, I was saying, I am the oldest one here, 48-year-old, but all my colleagues are, very young and warm-blooded, all of them here, Neeraj, Pankaj, Gaurav, Satish, JD, Tapas, Jay, all of you, thank you so much. I was trying to find out a picture which has all of you, couldn't find in the last moment, but thank you so much.
So one viewer commented on your handwriting also. So he said that very bad handwriting, sir. You should improve your handwriting.
Yes. Thank you. I agree. I completely agree that my handwriting is bad, but I can only blame my parents for that, because they did not put me enough pressure to make sure that I write good. So I'm back here with my good handwriting. Let me try to write something better now. Is this better? I am really.
So now we cannot see your screen. Now we cannot see your screen.
For.
Yes, now we can.
My hand writing will try to
So, sir, I hope that you will find something interesting, maths and handwriting relation also sometime.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah. We'll try to do that. But I'm sorry about the handwriting. Hopefully.
Some students are also the model you showed and demonstrated and mentioned.
Yeah, so a lot of the models that we have done are basically 3D structures, because my interest lies a lot. You should have seen the video of or the picture of 3D those domes that we built. One of them is actually at ICER Pune, 15-foot dome. For those who are in Pune, you can go watch it. Or those in IIT Gandhinagar, there is a bigger one at IIT Gandhinagar, 25-foot. All of those are absolutely beautiful structures that we have done with just bamboo sticks, because they are all derived of this this thing called the icosahedron. Let me just, if I have, if you see, this is the structure out of which all those structures are derived. Basic structure, icosahedron, 20 triangles, and it looks the same from any side. But the most beautiful part about this structure is that from one side it is 20 triangles, but from the other side actually it is just 3 golden rectangles. So 3 golden rectangles and 20 triangles are exactly the same thing. 3 golden rectangles are also right here. So the most beautiful thing is that this structure and this structure are exactly same. Aapko lagega ye kaise? But inke points agar hum join kar denge, you will get 20 triangles. See, because this has 12 nodes also, points. This has also 12 points. 3 rectangles, each rectangle 4 points, 12. And this has 12 points. तो मैथ गिव्स यू अ डिफरेंट पर्सपेक्टिव. एक तरफ 20 ट्रायंगल है, एक तरफ 20 ट्रायंगल है और एक तरफ 3 रेक्टेंगल है, दोनों एग्जैक्टली सेम चीजें हैं. सो प्लीज डू विजिट द वेबसाइट, प्लीज लुक फॉर फ्यूचर वीडियोस एंड फ्यूचर एपिसोड्स वेयर वी गो इनटू डिटेल्स ऑफ ऑल ऑफ दीस 3D स्ट्रक्चर्स. दिस इज व्हाट आल्सो इज समथिंग दैट इज इंटरेस्टिंग टू अस एंड वी डू. एनीथिंग एल्स? So I think we are above time. It is also, I see it is 12:20 right now. So really want to thank everybody who's watching from everywhere. Thank you so much for joining. Thank you so much for listening to this mathologue, long math session. Hopefully we have been able to bring back a little bit of love for the subject for you, just like we have been interested. So thank you so much, everybody from CCL, the whole CCL team. Thanks you. And like I said, CCL team comprises of, Neeraj, Pankaj, Gaurav, Jay, Tapas, Sarita, JD, and Satish and Mika. And of course, the person who really helped with the video camera, Vipul Bhai. So thank you so much, everybody. And over to you. If there are no more questions, Ankish and Dinesh, over to you in Pune.
Thank you, sir, for your time. And I hope that, and this time also, there was a huge hike in the, you can also see the nearly 10,000 people joined this time. Thank you very much. So coming back to the Ashok, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, Manish. Thank you very much for you and your entire team for such a wonderful both session. First demonstration and of course the question answer session. And I would like to remind for all the audience, please subscribe our both the channels, ICER Pune Science Activity Center and of course CCL IIT Gandhinagar. And definitely for more interesting demonstrations and activities, we will come back again on the next Sunday at 11 o'clock. And so basically we are trying to deal with all the subjects, physics, chemistry, biology, mathematics. So next session is dedicated on the chemistry activities. So please, we will see you again on the next Sunday at the same time. Okay, thank you. Meanwhile, bye-bye.